fucking play some Moonlighter. If you guys haven't played this, I highly recommend it. Super, super fun indie game. 10 out of 10 in my opinion. Just phenomenal. I have played it on hard, but for YouTube's sake, we're just gonna play it on normal. It's more time efficient and all that. Yeah. My apologies. Just gotta get through the little tutorial. Wait, isn't there a way to... Yeah, okay. There we go. Fucking chaos. Don't worry, you're meant to die here. This is not how the whole game is. I'm just, I'm curious how long I can last. Apparently not very long. That's the most shit I've ever had in that room. The game wants you to die right there. So he walked in there with a broom, and anyway, so I started blasting. Alright, so the general concept is, you go into the dungeons, you collect stuff, you bring them back to the shop, and you sell them, and then you can use the money that you got from selling the shit that you got in the dungeons to buy better equipment. Dangerous to go alone. Take this. So during the day, you sell, and during the night, you go into the dungeon. Obviously, that one's gonna be too much. That's just to teach you. This will give you a price list for everything. To the dungeons we go. Now that we have actual equipment, we can make it much further. Until you beat the boss of one dungeon, the next dungeon door will not open. Those are actually kind of worth a little bit. You can use jellies to make potions. Yeah, okay. And it's gonna force us to leave. But when you leave with the pendant, you get to keep all your shit. For a price. I don't fucking have any capital. I don't know what you're talking about. Yeah, you can upgrade your town and your shop and stuff. Alright, so we're going to change the price of that. Down to 100 where it's supposed to be. It's like right there, and I want to say you're 1,000. These are like 50 or 10 or something like that. So we're gonna go to sleep, and then we'll open. And we'll see what's what. Awesome if you guys would look at the table where the stuff is actually at. Too high. Also too high. Damn, I forgot all of the prices. You get the point of this, though. Still too high. These aren't worth shit. Edit that price and see what he does. No, too much. You'll notice the time dial at the bottom. Still too much. Maybe the prices change every game. Wouldn't that be a kick? There we go. And that's the end of the day. You get an itemized list of everything that you sold and what for what price, total earnings. Now it's off to the mine that we go, or the dungeon, as it were. It's pretty fucking neat, isn't it? I'll explain what those symbols mean later on. They drop their shit and it's like above a cliff, there's a very strong chance that it's just gonna fall and disappear if you don't collect it right away. These things heal you up all the way. Also, when you see these, you know that the next room is the like the mid dungeon boss room or whatever, that it's going to take you to the next floor. When you see twinkling like that in the dark, it means that there is a sub-level. Okay, so, anything that you have in this top section right here, you will definitely keep in the event that you die. These symbols, depending on what the symbol is, you have to place them a certain way in your inventory, or it will not let you keep them. So see, that has to be placed at the top or bottom. You get the point. So typically you want to keep your more expensive stuff at the top. Potion. Those are notes left by Pete, old Pete. You can read them for story value, but they don't really contribute anything. Aside from that, they do not assist with the gameplay. Wait, why is there a mystery? Why is there a question mark on there? Oh yeah, we already went in there. Right then. These heal you up to 100% if you soak. And just in case we die in here, those are actually worth a little bit more than those. I could have swore that there's a way to drop these. No? Well, poop! Right when we get some high value stuff, right? Once we get... Oh crap. Alright. It is what it is. Can't really do anything about it. Time to open up shop. If they end up sitting there for too long and you make them wait, they'll either walk out with it or they will leave it on the counter. Books are usually worth quite a bit. Thank you. See, now we're starting to rack up those big bucks. When you have people come in that have that, like, a weird symbol above their head, that hints to tell you specifically if they're looking for a certain item. So if you've come across any weapons or shields or anything like that, these people will buy them off of you. Sell these, please. Good rule of thumb, empty out your inventory. I'm going to show you how to make some potions. Come down here to... Oh, she doesn't live here yet. I thought she came with the village by default. Now she does. Might as well just go ahead and grab the blacksmith at the same time. For that right away, and then after that we're gonna go for that maximize profit. In the meantime, potions, we're gonna grab 5. Now we're going to assign them. And we're going to come talk to the blacksmith so that we can highlight the items we need for a weapon. I'm pretty partial to these because they're very fast. So by adding it to the wish list, that will highlight the items that we need to gather. So we need 1, 1, and 5. And now it's off to the dungeon again. That is not the weapon I want. Well, that didn't take very long to find that. Hell yeah. Okay, so. See the little star symbol? That means that's a highlighted item for your wish list stuff. So we're going to put that up above. Along with our most valuable stuff that we have at the moment. Heal. There we go. What do you know? There's another book. So once you reach a point where you've got a lot of stuff and you want to get rid of your lower value stuff, just come to a chest and you can drop this crap off. Shit that you know is just not worth very much money. And that way you have room for more valuable stuff. Okay. I didn't even notice this door. Thank you. Now, we got one more room we can go in. Oh yeah, while we're here. Usually you can end up condensing your inventory, because there are some items that just will not stack by default. You have to do it manually. Okay, so this is actually a portal that leads into a small section of the next dungeon. Upside, more valuable shit. Downside, more dangerous enemies. We got 3 potions, and we do have some slots, so we're gonna gamble it. There wasn't really anything that valuable in here this time. Sometimes you get lucky though, and there's quite a bit of stuff. Cinder, head on back where we came from, grab some more potions. Hopefully we have everything that we need for that weapon. Oh crap, I was looking at the wrong thing. Whoops. Alright, so we're not going to sell anything that is going to be used for that weapon. We're gonna hold on to all that. Usually I start with the most expensive stuff. Once I have the prices figured out, I'll try to sell that first. Thank you. Okay, so we know the prices on both of those things are too much. We're still going strong. Hopefully we can sell these two things up here. Nailed that one perfectly. There we go. And there we go. Our most profitable day yet. I forgot to grab potions. Oh no. And we keep finding that thing very quickly. Oh no. Well, that works. These things, you need to make them crash into a wall. Or anything to get them to stop. While they're in motion, you can't really damage them. There's a pet. You will sometimes find pet eggs inside of dungeons. Depending on which pet you have with you, it will boost various stats. Yeah, we'll keep it like that. We actually got 2 eggs in one go. That was lucky. Value shit. Oh shit. I didn't mean to do that. Whoops. We do need those, so we're gonna go to a chest and get rid of our junk. No. No, no. No. Yeah. Blacksmith a friend a visit. And then our eggs are in this pen right there. Once they hatch, we can equip them. We need one more bar. See if we can get any armor. We do not have anything. We're just gonna go right back into the dungeon. See why I bought those gloves. Super fast melee. The spear is also pretty good for ranged. And then you got a bow and arrow and sword and shield and a great sword. And there's lots of options for what you can do. Light armor, move fast. Heavy armor, slows you down. Yada yada. We're just going to keep gathering supplies. So much faster. You know what, fuck it. Let's go to the next floor. Better drops. We just gotta beat this guy. Obviously, the dungeon gets more and more dangerous the deeper you go. Oh yeah, this thing. This thing's nice. So it lets you sell shit in your inventory right then and there for, like, not at all as much money, but getting rid of the small shit that you don't need, that comes in handy. This destroys whatever you have that arrow is pointed at. So, for instance, that way at least you're not losing all of the profit from that item. Thank you. What do we want to get rid of? Shit, there's an egg. See what I mean? More stuff, better stuff, just more dangerous. Alright, get rid of this asshole first. Back we go. Man, I am hungry. Let's see what we got. Lovely. Well, at least we have one piece of armor. if you want to save, you gotta sweep in your bed. Alright, well, that's Moonlighter. Thanks for tuning in to the episode. Be sure to watch out for more. Definitely be playing more of this. Check out some of the other content on the channel. Like, comment, subscribe, blah, 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 blah. Check out the Twitch, Ultra Nerds. Yada, yada. See you next time.